Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The campaign to overturn Maine's new gay marriage law is heating up within the Catholic Church. A double collection during Sunday services today as their traditional basket is passed among parishioners. The church says it needs the money to help repeal the law allowing gays and lesbians to marry. News 8's Jim Keithley reports on the controversial move and is tonight's top story.
Inside the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception, Portland's largest Catholic church, beautiful music this Sunday morning, and the passing of the basket. Money's collected, usually going to support church functions. Today, a double passing to pay for TV ads aimed at overturning a state law just passed that allows gays and lesbians to marry. Outside the church, two former nuns now belong to a group called Catholics for Marriage Equality, both disappointed.
The fact that the bishop and the Catholic Church is coming out to help reverse the law for same-sex marriage is just appalling to me. It just doesn't feel right. It feels very unjust. It feels very discriminating.
Can you imagine this elegant God of the universe worrying about the appropriateness of marriage for two people who love each other, who just happen to be of the same sex? You know, I can't.
Sometimes the answer
back inside the sermon continues. The marriage equality law taking center stage, the pastor telling the faithful to ask themselves, what would Jesus do?
Marriage predates government. Since the beginning of time, marriage has been understood by people of every faith and culture to be the union of a man and a woman.
And then it was time for the second passing. Parishioners we spoke with say they believe the new law is not in keeping with what God would want.
I hope we can go back to the tradition as it was, that marriage should be between a man and a woman, at least in the state that I live in.
This isn't the only church taking part in the double collection. Mark Muddy from the group Stand for Marriage says 140 churches across the state are doing the same thing. And by the end of the day, they could collect as much as $100,000 to $300,000.
We don't have endless resources, and we are scrambling to put the resources together to fund our media buy.
Along the church fence, a handful of protesters dressed as angels. They carried signs. One read, "For heaven's sake, all love is divine. Vote no on one." And in 8 weeks, people of Maine will vote yes to repeal the marriage equality law or no to keep it on the books. In Portland, Jim Keithley, News 8.